Now let us solve one problem. F of x is equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 9x plus 5. Whether the function attains maxima or minimum value, its differentiation must equal to 0. That is what we have seen. That means dy by dx is equal to 0 and d square y by dx square is less than 0 for maxima, and dy by dx is equal to 0, d square y by dx square is greater than 0 for minima. These are two conditions. So differentiation of first function, given function with respect to x, is equal to 0 and here also equal to 0. That means whether it attains minimum value or maximum value, the first derivative must equal to 0. So whether particularly it attains maxima or minima, we have to go for verification of the second derivative. Already we have seen. So first let us make first derivative equal to 0, d by dx of f of x. So differentiation of this, what do you get? X cube differentiation is 3x square minus 6 is constant, x square differentiation is 2x plus 9 is constant, x differentiation is 1 plus 0. So it is 3x square minus 12x plus 9 is equal to 0, because first derivative equal to 0, whether it attains maxima or minima. So I can write, I can take 3 common, and x square minus 4x plus 3 equal to 0. So from quadratic equations we know how to calculate the roots. X square minus 4x can be written as minus 3x minus x plus 3 equal to 0. So product and sum of roots. So x you take common, x minus 3, minus 1 you take common, x minus 3 equal to 0. Again x minus 3 you take common, so x minus 1 equal to 0. So product will be 0, means either one equal to 0. X minus 3 equal to 0, x is equal to 3. So x minus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to 1. So at 3 and 1, it may attain maximum value here or minimum value. It may attain maximum value here or minimum value. Whether at x is equal to 1 it attains maxima or minima, to test it again we have to go for double differentiation. So we know f of x is equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 9x plus 5, and d by dx of f of x is equal to 3x square minus 12x plus 9. Again differentiate it, d square f of x by dx square is equal to 6x minus 12. Now you substitute 1, d square f of 1 by dx square is equal to 6 into 1 minus 12, you will be getting minus 6, this is less than 0. So at x is equal to 1 it attains maximum value, that's all, less than 0. And at x is equal to 3, d square f of 3 by dx square is equal to 6 into 3 minus 12, so you will be getting 18 minus 12, that is equal to 6, that is greater than 0. So you will be getting at x is equal to 3, you'll be getting minimum value, because double differentiation is positive. Yeah. Now how to calculate maximum value of f of x and minimum value of f of x? Because f of x value only we have to calculate, the maximum value of f of x and minimum value of f of x, that we can do by substituting x is equal to 1 in f of x, we will then calculate the maximum value of this function. By substituting x is equal to 3 in this function, we can calculate a minimum value. So f maximum, here f maximum is equal to, we will get by substituting x is equal to 1, so 1 cube minus 6 into 1 square plus 9 into 1 plus 5. So 1 minus 6 plus 9 plus 5, what you are going to get? Plus 6 minus 6 cancel, so 9. This is maximum value of f. and minimum value we will get by substituting x is equal to 3 in this function. So f minimum is equal to 3 cube minus 6 into 3 square plus 9 into 3 plus 5. So 27 minus 9 into 6 54 plus 27 plus 5. What you are going to get? 27 plus 27 54 cancel. So you will be getting 5. This is minimum value, this is maximum value, and whenever you substitute x value any other than these values, you'll be getting the f of x value is in between 9 and 5 only. So 9 is will be the maximum and 5 will be the minimum.